Let's talk all things. Let him in. I know that some people are probably accustomed to the live element of me, the praise and worship part of me, but there are some parts musically that people are not aware of. I grew up in a very musical household. Both parents, singers, sang R&B, and so it was a very colorful house. Rehearsals being held there, all of that good stuff. And a lot of the music was that old school R&B, you know, the OJs, Earth, Wind & Fire, Aretha, Shaka, Gladys was a staple in our home as well. And I grew up listening to so much goodness. And I was able to take that and develop my sound. Let Him In happened because we were done doing a demo. Philip Bryant, the producer, we were done doing a demo for a song and had enough time to create some more. And I just got this urge to do something nostalgic, something old school, and something that reminded me of my mom, my late mom. And I remember growing up in the house, and I remember hearing my mom sing Gladys Knight. I remember my mom singing Dorothy Moore. Woo, Jesus. She had this beautiful song. And I said, my mom used to sing that song. And what if I did something that felt like Misty Blue? And then the process started. And I promise you, the first line was, I am in love with a man who has all power in his hand. A love that's so deep, while in it I've drowned. Still can't believe in this love I found. And Philip got inspired and started writing as well. And I just needed that feel, that warm feeling to express and to convey the message. And throughout writing the song, I was like, whoa, we can really invite people to let God in. You know, although some may deem it a worldly sound, I don't see it through those eyes because of my beautiful musical upbringing from my parents. And I remember the scripture in Revelation, the book of Revelations, Revelation 3:20, when Jesus said, behold, I stand at the door and knock. And if any man hear my voice and open the door, your heart, open the door, I will come in. What? Any man that hear my voice and open the door, I will come in and I will sup with him and him with me. And I was like, whoa, what a fellowship. Like, I wonder, do people really understand that this can happen? And so through and through, it's a love song that I absolutely love and adore. I love the message because I was intentional about the sound of the song. So it may throw some people, but once they hear the message in the song, I believe that people will gravitate to it. And so for all of you that got the song, streamed the song, thank you. For those of you that messaged me and said that the message is beautiful, thank you, because that is really what I was trying to convey. So that's how we got Let Him In, y'all. That's how we got the song.
One more. One, two, three. Excellent. Yeah.
let him in the video. I remember thinking to myself, since it's such a retro song, well, the sound of it, I think the video should match it. I really do. I think the video should match. And I called up Steph, who is the founder of Red Alliance Media. Shout out to Steph. And I called her because I was so excited. I said, I think I have an idea for a music video. And I ran it by. I said, okay, just picture it. We're in like this, I said, it's like a mix between a juke joint, slightly Cotton Club, but not quite Cotton Club, but a little bit more on the juke joint side. And I'm up singing, I have an announcer, and I get up and sing, and people are like, where did this lady come from, or whatnot. I'm extremely nervous because I'm in a place where all of this stuff is happening. I said, what if we had, you know, a level of discomfort or conviction to happen in the video? Like, I start singing, I'm in love with a man, and people get excited, like, well, right now, she, you know, she love a man. Well, with all power in his hand, it's like, okay, what's happening right now? And then the second verse, and then the bridge, and, you know, and by the time I get to the bridge, just like full conviction, and people are really turning over, and their heart postures are turning towards God. And I said, that's the point, right? Not to bash them over the head, but to let them know that we have a God that forgives. That's the message, that we have a God that forgives, and that whatever it is that they were caught doing in that moment, that they're so convicted that they stop. So if we have a drunk that he sobers up in that moment, sobers up just enough to say, you know what, God, I don't need to be doing this to myself. I'm going to let you in, and I'm going to turn this over. You had a lady, I said, I was specific about cigarettes, and, you know, because that was the time back then. And I wanted to reflect that as much as I could. I said, but, you know, just to let them know by the end of the video, like, we're our hands are up. We're surrendered. Like, we're about to surrender our lives to the Lord. So, and she thought it was a phenomenal idea. And Steph is so creative. She was like, oh, we can have a pickpocket. We can have somebody selling cigarettes. And she's picking the man's pocket, getting money out of his pocket. And I'm like, wow, you're genius. Oh, I can order this, and I can order this. And oh, we can do the cigarettes that they use in the movies, you know, that they're not real, but they can. Steph went in, and it was so incredible. And she said, well, do you have a location? I was like, I do. I said, do you remember Jeffrey Lampkin's place in South Carolina when we went last year? She said, oh, yes, that would be perfect. I said, I knew it. And we called up Jeffrey. He and his wife, they were on board. Thanks. Shout out to Jeffrey. Thank you so much for allowing us to use your amazing place. And then she said, you know who would kill this video? Because that's how Steph talks. Who would kill this video? I said, I already know who you're talking about, Narel. And he was so on board. And he's such an amazing director. Just, he has the grace for it, the patience for it. And shout out to you, man, for just coming through and just making it easy for us. But that was the gist of it. So that was the idea. And I must say that it exceeded my expectations. The finished product exceeded my expectations. So I feel it was done in excellence. I feel like it was great. I feel like it was all that we needed and more. So thank you for allowing us to create and present you this very fine video. Oh, the dresses. The attire for Let Him In. Let's start with the cover. I remember calling up Tierra Blunt. That's my stylist. She's been my stylist for the last, I want to say 8 years. Whoa, 8 years, girl. And I called Tia. I was like, oh, I have this idea about a cover for Let Him In. And I said, you have to hear the song and for it to make sense. And because I like to do that so the creative can sense where we're going, you know. And I let her hear it, and she was like, yeah. I said, so I'm sensing like a cross between Color Purple, Shug Avery, and Harlem Nights, maybe, or something in that vein. Even Chicago, like what I saw with the movie and the play and everything. I said, so, you know, something in that element. And she said, hold, please. And do you know, 5 minutes later, this girl sent me a whole style board, like, ma'am, this fast? And I ordered all the stuff, and it came in 2 days. Come on, Amazon Prime! And so it was a blessing. So that was the cover. She said, do you mind wearing red? Because red is actually my least favorite color to wear. And I was like, you know what? I'm on board. Teamwork makes the dream work. So I'm on the team, and I'll do what I need to do to get it done. So that was the cover. And so when it came to the video, she came back after she got the vision of the video. And she said, do you mind wearing red again? But all red? I was like, yes, I'll wear the red. Teamwork makes the dream work. Thank you for putting up with me, T. And I said, but the red dress, I want that dress to be made. So I remember a friend of mine, Terrell. She goes by T.S. Couture. Follow her. She's phenomenal, beautiful human being. And I remember seeing her in this navy blue dress back in January. And I remember reaching out to her a couple of days after that. And I said, so yeah, that dress. And this was January this year. I said, I'm gonna need that. You go make me that dress. She said, I'm gonna make it for you. And months went by. And so when she said a red dress, I remembered the dress Terrell made for herself and wore. And it was a navy blue dress. It was just beautiful and phenomenal. And Tierra went to her and said, we need that dress in red. And Terrell came through, y'all. She sent my measurements and nothing needed to be adjusted. This is how much of Terrell just got it. She just got it. You know how many things Terrell has made for me? And we just sent the measurements and she sent it to me and I just put it on and it was a perfect fit. That's Terrell. So thank you, Terrell, for coming through with the red dress in the video. The hat came Amazon, the gloves, the shoes. I actually blessed somebody with those shoes at the video shoot. And that was that look for the red dress. And then the black dress, that was easy. I had that. That came with the cover dress. So I had that already. And I said, we're good to go. The hair. Oh, my goodness. The hair. Shout out to Herman Taylor. Jesus, phenomenal hairstylist. He did my hair for both the cover, single cover, and the video. And he came on through with what he does best, honey. And that's just latest good hair. Okay, we honor the Lord. Then there's Millicent out of Birmingham, Alabama. Millicent just got it, y'all. She's one of the most phenomenal makeup artist ever. We got acquainted with her when Kent was on the scene. Love you, Kent. And when Kent couldn't make it to something, I would always say, Kent, check these people out. Like, you know, check them out. So with the help of him and Tierra, we found Millicent. And she's been here, you know, and she's phenomenal. So shout out to Kent and Tierra for finding Millicent for the cover, not for the actual video. And she did her good work. She do a mean red lip too. Man, I said, doggone it. You're just good. You're just phenomenal. The team was amazing. Aaron, behind the scenes stuff, like my whole squad was there. My singers came, y'all. My singers came, drove from both near and far to come and participate. Just a few of my singers. I have quite a bit. If you follow, you know I have more than just three singers. So the three that was the closest, they came and participated in the video. And they did their good. They dressed real nice, hallelujah, and did their good acting. So I had Dion, the announcer, the MC that night, thank you. And for all that signed up and volunteered to come to be a part of the video shoot. You were kind, you were patient, and we love you for it. And y'all brought y'all good acting, okay? This wasn't no game. Like, they came ready to shoot and did a phenomenal job. So thank you all from the bottom of my heart. We filmed in Sumter, South Carolina. And like I said, the venue was perfection. It was perfect. It was beautiful. And it was top notch. Everything was excellent. And to all of you creatives out there, hear me and hear me good. Do not be afraid to create. I'm going to say that again. Do not be afraid to create. A box is for limited people. Don't live in that place. Seek God in all that you do. Do it with humility and gratefulness, but whatever you do, be your authentic selves. It matters. It matters to God. Don't hold back because of other insecurities. Don't hold back because someone says, well, this isn't, you know, what we're supposed to do, or this isn't what. No, we serve the God that created the heaven and the earth. So creative that he spoke it into existence. Remember the God that you serve, the Almighty God. Remember the God of the Bible. Remember all that he did. Remember the likeness you were made in. Don't be ashamed to create. That God has placed in you is for a reason. Some gifts may need to sit for a while to mature, but it doesn't mean that you're any less. You were created in his image. You are phenomenal. If people say that you're weird, okay, that's fine too. But whatever you do, take the limits off of God. Don't be afraid to express yourself in him. It's a beautiful thing to see. And I can't wait to see what you all do in the near future. I'm excited for you, you creative. I'm excited for you. I'm excited about your now. I'm excited about your next. And guess what? We need you. We need you to help us to convey some things. You're necessary. And believe it or not, there's a place for you. Mm-hmm. There's a place for you. So whatever you do, do it all in humility and gratefulness to God, who is the giver of life, and he gives us the gifts. Now go and create.